Call Brian.
Calling Brian.
So you just saw me make a phone call here in 2019 through, actually this was the Lenovo Smart Display, but you can also do it through the Google Home Hub, a Google Home Mini, and any really Google Home or Google Assistant enabled device. So if you want to know how to do that here in the next 10 minutes, stick with me. Let's get going. Over time, what I'll tell you is that it's become less and less complicated, but there are more places for settings to kind of trip you up here in your Google Home application. So that's what we're going to be in today, the Google Home application. Now I'm using an iPhone. If you have an Android phone, this becomes a little bit easier. Some of these steps you will not have to follow. But for now, let's go ahead and go into the Google Home application. Now, what I'm going to say is that in your initial setup process, if you've already turned on personal results, then you're a long ways down this path. But sometimes when people have turned on personal results, enabled voice calling, they're still struggling with naming someone and going ahead and making a phone call. So let's go through a few of the settings that will help you get there. Now, before we go too far into the demo here, I did want to stop for a second and talk about what you need and where you need to be. So you do need to be in the US, Canada, or the UK to still in 2019, right now, to make phone calls. Now, that list can always change and you can always find that on Google's support page. Now, what I'll say is that US and Canada people can make calls through their Google Home or Google Assistant enabled devices to US and Canada. If you're in Alaska or Hawaii, sorry, you're out of luck. But also from the UK, they can make calls to the UK, but you cannot make from the UK to Canada and the US, or from the US and Canada to the UK. So there are some restrictions on calling, and there are lots of countries that still do not have this feature. Nonetheless, if you'd like, you could try a whole house VPN service. And you know, I've been playing with a couple here, not having a lot of success in terms of whole house services, but over time I think I will get this hammered out, and then there'll be a new video here on the channel for those of you in different countries. So the other thing you need to make sure of is that your firmware is up to date. At least you have to have 1.36.141215. So you'll find that in the device settings, which we're going to go into here in a second as we get into the setup process. The first thing I'm going to tell you to make sure is a couple of settings. Personal results needs to be turned on, and you need to voice match. Now, if you have multiple people in your home and you want to be able to access, you know, their different contacts, you're going to have to do this in multiple accounts, and they're going to have to be voice matched in each case. So what we're going to do today is do the process for one person. But what I want to make sure here, and I just went into my device settings, and up in the top right, I hit the gear. You have a linked account list here, and I'm hiding mine, but you need to make sure that your account is listed here as a linked account. And once you do that, then we can go ahead and make sure that that account is voice matched to the device. So now back in the home screen, I'm going to go over to the account button, and up at the top again, I'm blanking out my account, but that account is the one, if you are the owner of that account, you want that to be on the device. So it needs to be on that linked device, and you need it showing up here at the top while you're doing this process. So now I'm going to scroll down and go to more settings. And this is our basic, this is our full setting screens, more or less, for all of our devices here, and really the Google Assistant in general. So I'm just going to go down inside of the Assistant menu here, and you can see Voice Match. Now, Voice Match here, it's basically for me, I've already set it up on all of these devices, so I don't need to worry about this, but it is showing me all the different devices that my personal voice match is set up on. Now, if I was struggling to get the voice assistant to understand me, right here, teach my assistant my voice again, I can go ahead, I can tap on that, and it will retrain, it'll do the whole process again. So if you're just struggling with your Google Home or your smart display device, if you're just struggling with it understanding you, then this is a good place to come. So once you've retrained your voice or you've made sure that your device is listed here, then we're done basically half of this process. Now, again, back inside the More Settings screen, and I'm in Assistant again, and I scroll down and I need to find my display. Now this one's called Kitchen Display. We've already been in there once. So I tap into there and now I have a whole new settings screen for this device, but it's related to the assistant settings on this device. You can see personal results right there. So we're going to make sure that that is turned on like it is. So that button has to be slid to the right and you have to see the blue there, okay? That's personal results. That means you're able to access your calendar, your contacts, all of those things here on the device. Now, another thing is down here at the bottom, the Duo Video Call. What you'll see for most people, if you don't have Duo Video Call already set up, is a little link chain, and I'm going to show you that a little later on my Google Home Hub. So, that once you have these two things, the personal results are all set up, you're basically ready. But I'm going to show you a couple more things just to make sure your contacts have been synchronized. And this is the big thing for a lot of people, especially with an iPhone. So now back into that More Settings screen. So really we're staying in the same screen here and we're going to go over to Services. Now from Services, you're going to see an option of Voice and Video Calls. And here I'm going to show you how to set up both. So when you go into this screen the first time, if your contacts have not been synchronized, they are right below Video and Voice Apps. You'll actually see the ability to upload your contacts. Once you do that, your phone will on occasion upload and synchronize your contacts. So you don't need to worry about that once you've done that. But what I'll tell you is you hit that button, it starts the process. 10 seconds later, you're not going to be able to make calls to people you want to make calls to. So you've got to give it a little time to synchronize with Google services once you've done that. If you're not seeing that, at the end of this video or towards the end of this video, I'm going to give you another method of basically how to get your contacts uploaded in a manual way to Google. So inside of this screen, there's a couple of options you're going to want to go into. Inside of mobile calling here, you have your own number linked. And once you do that, so basically I just went in again and I can add or change the phone number. Now, as I type in my phone number on my device, what happens is you get a text message, and I can go ahead and I could show you how to do this, but we don't need to do it. All you do is you type in your phone number and you hit that verify button up in the top right. Once you hit that verify button, it will send you a text message and you need only to put that number back in, that 6-digit number that Google sends you. Once you've done that, every time you make a phone call, it will show up with your phone number. Another choice for yourself is to use an unlisted number. Now, what I'll say in general is you probably don't want to do that, but you can tap that button and you will use unlisted. So every time you call, it will say basically unknown, no number. Now, I did promise I was going to show you how to connect your Google Duo account. So this video does assume you have a Google Duo account. If you don't, it's very simple to go get the Google Duo application, and basically you start an account with the same login that you've used on your Google account here. Once you've started that account and you can connect it to your phone again, your same phone number, then you come back to here into the voice and video calls and you just tap inside there, and what you're going to see is the ability to link. So you see the little chain link. You want to link your Google Duo account, so you have to pick your country here, and I'm going to go ahead and do that. And this is the same process for setting up your phone number as you set up regular calling here. So I'm just going to hit next, and it's instantly linked my account. You will likely have an extra step. I'd linked my account in the past. So more or less, we're ready to make phone calls, but some of you may be struggling. And so what I want to do is I want to give a demo here of how to make these phone calls. And then at the end, I'm going to give those of you that are still struggling a couple of more options and opportunities basically to get your contacts uploaded and synchronized here with Google servers. So we're going to start with the demo and then we're going to go forward and give some of those special situations treatment.
Call a contact.
Who do you want to call?
Brian.
Sure, calling Brian.
Mute.
Turning off the mic for this call.
9. End. Make a video call.
Who do you want a video call?
Alan.
Making a video call to Alan. By the way, this device doesn't have a camera, so they won't be able to see you. Video call for Brian. It's from Alan.
So for those of you that are still struggling getting your contacts uploaded, there are a couple of other capabilities basically for you to go ahead and get your contacts synchronized. Now, for those of you with an Android device, you're already using Google Contacts, so that's not a big deal. Your contacts should immediately synchronize. Once you've checked personal results and voice match, you should be good to go. Now, for those of us with an iPhone, here's one of the tricks that I want to give you. You can see my Google Assistant application here, and I'm going to go into that, and it uses the same account that I have that I want to use with this account. I've voice matched that account, and I've turned on personal results for that account. Now, what I can do is I can go into the settings, which is a tap top right, and this looks pretty similar, or this looks pretty much the same. When I go to my assistant settings and I scroll down, what you're going to find though is my iPhone is listed there. So these are the assistant devices now. So when I go into that, you can see right there, contact. So it's pulled over to the right, and this will help ensure that your contacts are getting to Google's server. So that this is a big deal for you now. This will get that moved over. Now, one last method for getting your contacts uploaded if all of this is failing for you. Starting in your iPhone settings, I'm covering it right now, but you're going to tap on where your name is. And then you're going to go into the iCloud settings. Once in there, look at the contacts section. Make sure that that little radio button is turned green or turned on, basically. That means that your contacts are syncing with the iCloud. And that allows us to go to iCloud.com, which is Apple's site that stores all of your iCloud information. You can gain access to it. So once you've logged in there with your same iCloud account, you simply click on contacts, and here's a list of your contacts in the cloud. So we're going to go down to the gear, click select all, and then we're going to export a vCard or export all of your contacts, whatever the setting is today. This will change over time. Now that you have that, we can go to contacts.google.com, and this is what the site looks like today. Now, I've already imported my contacts, but over on the left-hand side of this page, there is the option to import, and you select that same file here that you just got from your iCloud. And once you do that and you hit import, that's it. Your contacts are now uploaded. And again, give it some time before you try your Google Home. So there you have it, guys. Obviously, I've covered a ton here in my 2019 Making Phone Calls video. I hope this has all helped you out. And if it hasn't, of course, I'm always happy to help you guys out as best I can in the comments below. Obviously, I can't make Google go ahead and give you access to making phone calls if you're in one of those countries that doesn't have that functionality. But for today, guys, you should be able to, if you're in the US, UK, or Canada, make phone calls, whether or not you have an Android or an iPhone device. So thanks for watching, everyone. Here come the links to go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Please do that, and we'll see you next time.